Hey everybody, Chris here. Welcome to Crash Course APIs and Interactive Data. I'm really excited to be teaching this course online because I've been teaching it over a year for now as part of my Programming for Non-Programmers workshop, and I understand how confusing APIs can be for non-developers and even for beginner developers. So I put this together and I'm hoping this is going to make it a lot easier. We're going to answer the question, what are APIs? And we're going to do that by looking at, you know, how things work in real life, but also we're going to look at some code. Well, what is an API? Okay, so maybe you've heard someone say something like, the New York Times has an API we can use, right? Well, what do they mean? What they're trying to say is that the New York Times has some data, and that data is freely available, and we could use that in our project. Okay, so for example, the New York Times might have a lot of data about movie listings or restaurant reviews, real estate. All this kind of stuff is available, and you could use it on your site if you were to have a real estate site or you wanted to provide movie listings. It's pretty great. I'm going to use real-life examples throughout this so that we can relate to them and see it in action. To understand APIs, we need a little primer on databases and how databases work with web apps. I think understanding databases will be the first step to really understanding APIs from a technical point of view. There are thousands of APIs available right now that are free to use, and so we'll look at a few of my favorite examples and how to get started implementing them. And then we're going to look at real data and real code to see it in action. I think that's really the best way to learn what an API is. The first project we create will be with Facebook. We'll look at the Facebook developer site. I'll be providing you with some HTML and CSS, and we'll take that coding file and put in some of the Facebook API calls so that we can put a comment box on our site and make something that looks like this. And from there, we'll look at the Graph API Explorer to see what other data can I get from Facebook? What else have they let open in their database that I can store and put into my own project? The language of APIs is usually sent via JSON or XML code, and so we'll be looking at examples of each. The second project we work on will use the Twilio API. Together, we'll register for a Twilio account, set up a phone number, and use the Twilio API to write some basic code that allows us to write a message when anyone calls our phone number and automatically sends them an SMS back.
Hello, hope to see you in class.
The class blog is at pfnp.me, that's programmingfornonprogrammers.me, where I have various questions answered from students, recommendations on hosting and books and tutorials, where to go after this. Also, you can reach out to me on @gastig at Twitter before the class or even after the class. I'll try my best to get to any questions. And some of the best questions I get that are submitted, I put on the blog and write a tutorial about to try to help you if I think it's going to be useful for everybody. So check this out, and thanks for coming. I hope to see you in class.